When it comes to NASA, I think a lot of people initially think of rocket launches in Cape Canaveral or astronauts floating above the Earth in the International Space Station. But there's a lot of research and engineering and testing that needs to happen before anything can fly. And we have those capabilities: supersonic wind tunnels, microgravity drop towers, vacuum chambers, and a research aircraft hangar. And that's why people from all over the world come to NASA's Glenn Research Center right here in Cleveland, Ohio.
What we work on, power, propulsion, communications, you need it for anything that flies.
We like to say the road to the moon goes through Ohio, and that's because our test facilities are crucial to advancing the Artemis program.
Part of our vision for going back to the moon and establishing a sustainable presence is having a lunar gateway, a lunar space station that can fly successfully around the moon and sustain astronauts there. And we are leading the program that's developing the power and propulsion element.
NASA's Neil Armstrong Test Facility in Sandusky, Ohio. It's the only place in the world where you can test a full-size spacecraft for all the extreme conditions of launch and spaceflight.
Right now, we have the Orion spacecraft. This is a spacecraft that actually went around the moon, but we're using it as a test article now to make sure that in the launch environment, that spacecraft is safe.
When it comes to aviation, every U.S. plane has NASA Glenn technology on board, which makes your flight cleaner, safer, and quieter.
And looking at solutions like electric and hybrid electric propulsion systems that will reduce or give us different ways of converting energy that are cleaner.
Our center partners with a lot of community organizations to share NASA's discoveries or just get kids excited about science, engineering, technology, and math.
I really enjoyed the VR experience. It was really cool to be able to sit like I was an actual pilot flying. I feel like I could potentially look into considering aerospace.
We've also made it our mission to prepare Cleveland for the April 8th total solar eclipse.
We demonstrated different types of hands-on activities for educators to share with their students, as well as the science behind a total solar eclipse.
My favorite thing about Glenn is our people. Not only are they crazy smart, but they are genuinely good people. And we are literally part of almost everything NASA does. And so what's really great about being here is you're in the heart of it all.